25 years ago, on November 15, 1984, PPV, the world farmer's heart stopped beating, but the medical implication of a short life were just beginning. PPV was a pioneer, because on this year, Betty Nella transplanted baboon heart into Stephanie Chess, making her the first infant receiving cross-species heart transplant. This case was broke down inside, because it's wide horizontal curing people. You know, there is so many uncurable diseases which can be somehow treated by organ transplantation. And in that point, we meet challenge. There is not enough organ to cure everyone. To this day, 10 people on the waiting list for transplantation die every day due to the organ shortage. This severe shortage of organ promotes research to develop alternatives. One of them is animal transplantation, which is the transplantation of animal organ into human. Although this kind of operation encounters immunobarrier and cross-species infections, xenotransplantation transplantation is approach for quick and cost-effective supply of organ. In this presentation, I will discuss xenotransplantation transplantation in terms of advantages, disadvantages, and some ethical problems. I hope that by the end of my presentation, you will acknowledge xenotransplantation transplantation as an adequate solution for organ shortage. I'm not asking all of you agree with me, but I'm asking you to be open to this topic. First of all, I would like to start with adventures and transplantation. In this figure, you can see there is four of them. I would like to start with survival and longer people's life. First, adventures and transplantation is that xenotransplantation supply a lot of organ and longer people's life. The strongest candidate for transplantation is a pig, because it's anatomically and physiologically similar to men. It reproduces quickly, every 115 days, and have more than 10 offspring. The first attempt of animal-to-human transplantation was performed in 1916, with chimpanzee. The patient survived 9 months. In the next figure, by Copris and Egris in their article, Animal Transplantation 2012, you can see maximum period of survival of pig organ and cells. In this picture, you can see that neuronal cells, free pancreas cells, and corneal cells survived 1 year. Also, microencapsulated pancreas cell, hepatocytes, and gibbotronic hearts survived 8 months, and others for days and months. I would have said that this time is short, but every discovery in history must begin with little step. So I would like to move to my second point, is that xenotransplantation can be used as a bridge transplant, which means temporary transplantation of organ until human organ is available. In 2004, there was a study when 14 people with liver disease was provided with pig livers. 9 of them was successfully bridged, and 7 is survived their transplant. The third advantage of xenotransplantation is that xenotransplantation eliminates ethical problems. Cooper, in his article, xenotransplantation present position in 2004, stated two problems. First is clinical determination. It's a process of choosing who gets available organ. And the second problem is identifying and determining brain death. Because there was some cases that relatives choose a hospital, they said that doctor does not do everything to help the patients. So xenotransplantation solved this kind of two problems. And the last fourth advantage of xenotransplantation is that animal organ and tissues can be helped to treat many diseases. For example, like Parkinson's disease, HIV, insulin, diabetes, and other. Also, generative pig cells can be used to treat Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, Lou disease. Insulin, pig insulin, is already used to treat diabetes 1. Second point in this presentation is the disadvantage of xenotransplantation. Performing xenotransplantation encountered several problems. Hopkins stated two problems in his article called xenotransplantation benefit and hard choice. I would like to stop to each of them. First is that immunorejection, because human organism try to reject and fight against the new organ. And the second problem is transmission of infection disease. Concern arises around Parsin endometrial retrovirus. However, there were only 4 cases over 20 years of experiment. Although xenotransplantation encountered immunobarrier and transmission of infections, This problem of yours can be solved. And I would like to mention two solutions. First is immunosuppressive drug, which tends to stop rejection. And the second is genetic modification. So the transplanted organ becomes more compatible with human organism. My third point in the presentation is the ethics and religion. Many people mistakenly think that organ transplantation is prohibited by religion. To be honest, I also think so. And now, let's consider the main religions and their belief about organ transplantation. I would like to refer to article called Ethics of Organ Donation by Poland 2004. Judaic and Islamic law prohibit consumption of pig, and hence, transplantation abuse also should be banned. However, in emergency situation, both religions admit transplantation operation only for life-saving trial. Buddhists accept all organs in the case that this operation does not cause pain for anyone, because they believe that human is responsible for protecting anyone. Hindus believe that body should remain unchanged during the whole life. However, they don't ban donating or accepting organs. Catholics accept all organs, except glands and brain. Three main religions accept pig heart valves and insulin to kill people. So you can see that there is no religion or belief which directly ban organ transplantation if it deals with human life. To conclude, in this presentation I have discussed organ transplantation in terms of advantage, disadvantage and some ethical problems. The main purpose of my presentation was to persuade you that xenon transplantation has more advantages than disadvantages. Xenon transplantation is a potential solution for organ shortage for several reasons. First, xenon transplantation can supply a lot of organs, so reduce time on the waiting list and cost of operation. Second point, xenon transplantation can be used as bridging transplant, which is temporary transplantation of animal organ into human. And also, xenon transplantation can treat many human diseases like AIDS, Parkinson's disease, diabetes. And the third point is that xenon transplantation can eliminate many ethical problems. For example, clinical determination, which is the process of who get available organ. And the second problem is determining and identifying brain death. I would like to finish my presentation by a quote. You are born with the ability to change someone's life. Don't ever waste it. The only thing I'm asking you to change is your attitude to organ transplantation. Because changing attitude of one person will change attitude of whole society. As a study by Stanford shows, 20% of people refuse transplantation operation due to the ethics and other people's attitude. You can help those people by your positive attitude and support.